Good morning, all my dear fourth class students. How are you, Nana? Yesterday, first lesson textbook Samuli completed. No children, matching and two are false. Some pages objective type question answer. Some pages only completed. Now page number open. If you have a textbook, please open the textbook. If you have a textbook with you, please. Open the textbook and follow with me. Page number 7. Page number 7 open nana. Page number 7. I will show the textbook to you. Yes, children, see the textbook. Yes, let us practice. Here multiple choice questions are given, amma. Read the first question. Which of the following is an example of a tree that grows in hilly areas? Which plants grows in hilly areas? Cedar. Okay, lotus grows in the water. Okay, hydrilla grows in the underwater. So what is the correct option? Cedar. Okay, keep A. Okay, option A correct. Now second question, go to second question. Plants that grow in marshy areas are called marshy areas. Which plants grow in marshy areas? Mangroves. Mangroves are grows in marshy areas. Option A correct. Now third question. A lotus plant has needle like leaves, broad leaves and very thin leaves. Lotus plant has broad leaves. Now see the fourth question. Venus flytrap traps the insects with the help of their specially designed leaves. Is it clear? Specially designed leaves. One more time. Which of the following is an example of a tree that grows in hilly areas? Cedar. Second question. Plants that grow in marshy areas are called mangroves. Now third question. A lotus plant has broad leaves. Fourth question. Venus flytrap traps insects with the help of their specially designed leaves. Open next page. Page number 8. Page number 8 open, amma. Now see here, blanks are there. See here, amma, blanks. Fill in the blank. Page number 8, open the textbook. Page number 8, fill in the blanks are there. Roman B. Okay, read the first question. Trees growing in the hills have. Trees growing in the hills have dash A-shaped leaves. What type of leaves they have? Needle-like leaves. Leaves are very thin, no children. Leaves are very, very thin and looking like a needle and covered with waxy coating, no? So, trees growing in hills have needle-like leaves. Okay, needle-shaped leaves. Hilly areas plants, leaves are needle-like. Okay, second question, see. Plants in hot and dry areas are called... Okay, plants in hot and dry areas are desert plants. Okay, in desert weather is very hot, there is very little bit rainfall. Okay, now, so which plants grow in dry areas? Only cactus. Plants in hot and dry areas are desert plants. Write here cactus also. Okay, keep bracket and write cactus. C-A-C-T-U-S, cactus. Write, amma. Hot and dry areas are desert summer, desert summer, deserts plants. Okay, right example also here, cactus. Okay, third question. Trees in the plains shed their leaves. Shedding means lost their leaves. Trees in the plains, flat land, shed their leaves in winter. They cannot bear the cold climate. That's why some leaves may fall from the trees. Shedding means lost their leaves. Okay, trees in the plain shed their leaves in winter. Is it clear, Nana? Next question. Okay, see the question number 4. Wulfia. Wulfia is the floating plant. Wulfia is an example of floating plant. Wulfia, duckweed, water hyacinth. These plants float on the water surface. Okay, they are very small plants. That's why they float on the water surface. They don't have well developed roots. Okay, na stems are reduced, roots are not well developed. These are small plants. That's why they float on the water surface. So Wolffia, see here, Wolffia is an example of floating plant. Next question, see the fifth question. Underwater plants have no stomata. Actually, green plants have stomata underside of the leaf. Most plants have stomata. That stomata is present underside of the leaf. Underside of the leaf. But underwater plants have no stomata. But how do they breathe, Amma? They breathe through their body surface. These underwater plants, example hydrilla. Okay, hydrilla and see here, hydrilla plant completely mean the whole plant live under the water only. Whole plant live completely under the water only. Okay, na? So they don't have stomatas. How do they breathe? They breathe through the body surface. They breathe through the body surface. They have thin and narrow leaves and flexible stems. Amma. Okay, na? They breathe through their body surface and do not have stomata. Hydrilla. Okay, hydrilla and tape grass. These two plants live under the water only. The whole plant live under the water only. They do not breathe through stomata. They have to breathe through their body surface. So which plants have no stomata? Underwater plants, right? Underwater plants have no stomata. Is it clear? Now go for true or false. See Roman, true or false. See here, first question read, cactus makes its food by its spines. Cactus plants makes its food by its spines. Is it true, ma? No. Cactus plants makes its food by its stem only. Stem is green. I will show it to you. You go see here, ma. See here, cactus plant stem is green. Stem only performs the photosynthesis. Where are the leaves, Amma? Leaves are modified into spines. Okay, stem is green. Why it is green? Chlorophyll is present in the stem only. Stem only performs the photosynthesis. Okay, food materials, water is also stored in the stem. That's why it looks like fleshy and covered with waxy coating. Is it clear, Amma? Okay, they either have very few leaves or no leaf at all. Is it clear, Amma? So, green stem only performs the photosynthesis. They have spines instead of leaves. Is it clear? So, cactus makes its food by its spines. Is it true or false? It is a false. Okay, na? Cactus plant. Okay, see here. Cactus makes its food by its spines. False. Cactus makes its food by stem. Okay, so first one is the false. Okay, and the second one. Moulds and mushrooms are insectivorous plants. Is it true, Amma? False. Moulds and mushrooms are non-green plants. Mushroom, cactus, keep false, Amma. Second question read, moulds and mushrooms are insectivorous plants. Is it true? No. Moulds and mushrooms are non-green plants. Mushroom is a plant. Moulds also plant. Bread moulds. Okay, after eating the leftover food, keep in outside, Amma. Sprinkle some water. Black color plant-like structures are formed on rotting food materials, stale food materials. Those are the moulds. Okay, na? So, moulds, black color moulds and mushrooms are non-green plants, but they given here insectivorous plants. That's why second one is false. Is it clear? Yes, now it is clear. Yes, see here, Amma, moulds and mushrooms are insectivorous plants. False. Okay, third one, see, Third one, see, places with a sticky and clayey are called swamps. Places with sticky and clayey are called swamps. True. Okay, in marshy area, soil is very sticky and clayey. Mangroves are the plants grow in marshy places. Okay, na? So, it is true. Okay, places with sticky and clayey soil are called swamps. It is true. Now, fourth question, see, fourth question. Plants growing on hills are called aquatic plants. Is it true, amma? Plants growing in the water are called aquatic plants. Plants growing in the water are called aquatic plants. But here what they given? Plants growing in the hills are called aquatic plants. Is it true or false? It is a true, it is a false. Why it is false? Plants growing in hills are called hilly areas plants. Okay, means what they given here? Aquatic plants. Okay, that's why this statement is wrong, false. Now, fifth question, see. Mushroom is a non-green plant. Mushroom is a non-green plant. True. Okay, na? Okay, so one more time. Cactus makes its food by its spines. False. Mushroom and moulds are insectivorous plants. False. Okay, third question, see here. Places with sticky and clayey soil are called swamps. True. Fourth question, see, plants growing in hills are called aquatic plants. False. Now, fifth one, mushroom is a non-green plant. True. Come on, keep the answers carefully. See the board, amma. See the board, page number 8. Enter, amma. False, false, true, false, true. Enter. Now matching is there. Plants in marshes. Which plants grow in marshes? Plants in marshes. Which plants grow in marshes? Mangrove. Come on, keep option D. Okay, mangroves are the plants that grow in marshes. Okay, na? Option D. Keep option D. Now see here, second question. Plants on hills. Plants on hills. Fir. Okay, fir and pine and cedar. These plants grow on hills, no children, but they given only here fir. F-I-R, fir. Plants on hills are fir. Okay, come on, next question. Plants in the desert. Which plants grow in the desert? Cactus. Cactus grow in the desert. Option G. Is it clear, ma? Okay. Insectivorous plant. Venus flytrap is the insectivorous plant. Non-green plant. Moulds and mushrooms are the non-green plants. Now, underwater plant. Hydrilla and tape grass are the underwater plants. Underwater plants. Hydrilla. Fixed water plants. Lotus roots are fixed to the bottom of the pond. I come again, ma. Plants in marshes. Mangrove. Option D. Plants on hills. Fir. Option C. And plants in the desert. Cactus. Option G. Insectivorous plant. Venus flytrap and pitcher plant. Now, non-green plants, moulds and mushroom, but they given moulds. Okay, underwater plants, hydrilla and tape grass are the underwater plants. Okay, option A. Fixed water plants, lotus and water lily are the fixed water plants, but they given here only lotus. Okay, you have to keep option E. Is it clear, amma? One more time. Cactus makes its food by its spines. False. Moulds and mushrooms are insectivorous plant. Moulds and mushrooms are non-green plants, no children. They give an insectivorous plant. That's why false. Places with sticky and clayey soil are called swamp. Swamp, true. Plants growing in hills are called aquatic plants. False. Plants growing in the water are called aquatic plants. No children, that's why that is the false. Mushroom is a non-green plant. Mushroom is a non-green plant. Yes, mushroom is a plant, but they don't have chlorophyll. Okay, na? Lack of chlorophyll. That's why they do not make their own food. They depend on dead and decaying matter. That's why mushroom is a non-green plant. True. Once again, blank. See here, ma. Trees growing in the hills have needle-shaped leaves. Plants in hot and dry areas are deserts. Okay, na, cactus. Okay, trees in the third question. Trees in the plain shed their leaves in winter. Shed their means lost their leaves in winter. They cannot bear the cold climate. That's why some of the leaves fall from the trees. Now, fourth question. Wolfia is an example of floating plant. Floating. Wolfia is a small plant, lightweight plant, roots are not developed, that's why they float on the water surface. And fifth question, see, underwater plants have no stomata, but how do they breathe? They breathe through their body surface. Okay, page number 9, see here, they given only some pictures, amma. First one, right, cactus, C-A-C-T-U-S, cactus. Second one, very small plant, pond, surface fully covered with duckweed plants, very, very small plants. So, right, duckweed. Third picture, F-I-R, fir. Okay, snow falls on the branches of the plant. No. Okay, children, sloping branches, which help the snow to slide off easily. Okay, na? Sloping branches. Okay, na? If the snow falls on the branches of the tree, immediately snow fall from the branches of the tree. Snow slide off easily. Okay, na? Fir. And see here, this is the tape grass. Tape grass is underwater plants. Ripple-like leaves, narrow leaves, they breathe through their body surface. Tape grass. Okay, children, read today textbook grammar, textbook true or false matchings. Okay, today you have to read 6, 7, 8 pages from the textbook. Okay, this is a homework for you. Today you have to read 6, 7, 8 pages. Okay, read the textbook along with the grammar part. Blanks, true or false matching also there, amma. Okay, tomorrow I will tell you second lesson. Be ready with the textbook, children. Okay, na? First lesson, did you write the CW? Did you write the CW? You have to read short question and answers also. Okay, see you later. Bye.